So the Winnipeg Jets conclude a three-game road swing. They've lost the two previous two. They will go home for five in a row. Nikolai Khabibulin, the number one netminder for the Winnipeg Jets, making his 13th consecutive start, a record of 8-5, 3.39. And Don Beaupre, who was so outstanding early in the season for Rick Bonus, has settled down somewhat since then, but is still a number one man, 6-9. His record, 3.6, his goals against, and he has one shutout on the season. That was against the Hartford Whalers. The referee tonight is Dave Jackson, Stefan Provo, and Pierre Asico are the linesmen. Play is underway. It goes into the jet zone. Here's Quint trying to clear it. He can't. It's held in. A quick shot taken wide of the net by Jordan. Not dressed tonight for the Winnipeg Jets due to injury. Mike Stapleton, Dallas Drake, Jason Doig, Neil Wilkinson. And Ed Ronan also is a scratch tonight for the Ottawa Senators. Not in the lineup is Dave Archibald, who is a scratch. Scott Levins is out. Joe Sorella. Steve Duchesne has a sprained ankle. He's out for a while. A hip flexor is causing Troy Mallette to sit this one out.
Look for the Jets right away on Don Beaupre. They want to get the puck down and use the defense of the Ottawa Senators. Start cycling the puck down low. Get some good forechecking. The Senators have been giving up a lot of chances down low all season long.
Now the Senators down. Newman knocks it ahead. Musil chased there by Darren Shannon. It's along the boards. Grabbed by Finley. Finley in front. Jamnov shot. And the save by Beaupre. Jamnov appeared to have an open net. Took a whole lot of time. Probably too much. And Beaupre recovered.
Well, Jamnov, when things are not going well, this is the kind of thing that happens. You have chances to score. Maybe your confidence, your edge isn't quite there. And Jamnov has Beaupre down and out, but what a tremendous second effort by Don Beaupre, and somehow this puck does not go in. But a very nice pass as well by Finley to find Jamnov right in front. Now watch Beaupre. He's out of it here, but what a tremendous second effort. He just gets a piece of the puck. But once again, it's a little edge between scoring goals and not scoring goals. And right now, Jamnov just does not have that edge.
Last year, that was in.
Absolutely.
Off the draw, the puck goes into the corner.
Well, Alexander Daigle is going to have to prove not only to himself, but to his teammates and management, that he is the player that everybody thinks he is. Certainly what his salary demands anyway. And he was not playing. He was not happy with Rick Bonus at all. In fact, I think it's fair to say he was sulking. Now he's going to play a lot. And everybody's interested to see how he's going to respond to more ice time.
He's Drury back for Chorsky. The Senator cycling deep. It's taken in behind the net. Centered! The shot by Drury with Khabibulin down. He made the save. Then Khabibulin gave him some stick. And now the Jets and Drury do some shoving.
Well, this has been the best line for the Senators for sure. Chorsky, Drury working together very well down low. And they've been getting on the body, and that's why this has caused all kinds of problems. And you can see the original hit on Chorsky here as he puts him down, but Chorsky is really fighting hard down low and creating a lot of chances, and now he's going to head right for the net. Manson chases the puck carrier. And that's why Drury is wide open in front, and a very good save by Khabibulin to make this game still a 0-0 situation.
Only one. Here's Newman. To Tkachuk. To Newman. To Tkachuk. Tkachuk moves in deep. Here's Tkachuk. Over to Jamna. He Holchik scores.
What a wonderful goal by the Winnipeg Jets. This is as pretty as they come, folks. Eddie Olchuk, what a gift he receives from his teammates, but the work is all done by Tkachuk. He does everything on this play. Look at how strong he is with the puck. Stick to stick to Eddie Olchuk. No chance at all for Don Beaupre. Solani once again sees the ice so well. Watch how he finds the hole, the seam in between the box here, and picks off Netzcash, and that allows Ed Olchuk to be wide open in front of the net.
So Eddie Olchek with a three-point night in Boston yesterday gets the Jets on the scoreboard here tonight. Can't fool Hoffman. Puck is picked up by the Senators, put up along the boards. Now it goes loose. Here's Doan. He scored! Shane Doan gets his third goal of the season. It's 2-0 Winnipeg.
It's amazing when you shoot the puck what will happen for you. Shane Doan here, he just directs it towards the net. And a little bit of a screen possibly by Turcotte in front as he gets all tangled up in front of Don Beaupre, but it goes right on the far post. But once again, some good hard work by Chris King in the corner to set this play up. Turcotte with a nice little feed to Doan. He just puts it through traffic. Don Beaupre is caught a little bit too deep in his net. And that is a big, big goal for the Winnipeg Jets. Really takes the wind out of the Ottawa Senators' sail.
Shane Doan is third from Darren Turcotte. And 17-25, it's 2-0 Winnipeg. Here's Straka. Now it's dumped into the chat zone. Back to get it is Finley.
That 8-game losing streak.
Well, the Jets certainly started a little bit slow, but they really came on as the first period progressed, particularly on their power play, which got them started. And a good period for Khabibulin. He was sharp when he had to be, particularly on wraparounds, which he must have had two or three in the first period. But a good start for the Jets to take all the win momentum that the Ottawa Senators received from getting a new coach this morning out of their sails.
So on the up, it came at 17-25. Shots on goal in the first period by the Jets, 11 by the Senators, 9. Both teams a man short to open up this second period.
Dave Allison, you wonder what he said between periods to his team. Obviously, I'm sure he'd be positive in his first meeting. It's no time to start being animated quite yet, and there's a sign that has sort of been the feeling around Ottawa the last few days as far as the talk shows are concerned. There's been a lot of animosity in town, a lot of upset people that Rick Bowness has been let go. But that's Randy Sexton's job as a GM. He has some tough decisions to make sometimes, and he just made one, and the test of time will tell whether or not it was the right one or not.
Former Jet general manager John Ferguson has backed the move by the management at Ottawa and firing Bowness. Here's Straka. Here's Alfredson moving in. The save. Empty net. Alfredson shot, and he missed it. Good work by Daniel Alfredson. He gets back to get it again. Puts it in deep. Netzcash back for Alfredson. He cuts at the net. Now circles. Looks for a trailer. Finds Hill. Shot blocked by Turcotte. Hill gets it again. Puts it behind the net. Both clubs playing a man short. There's no advantage here, but the Senators look like they're on a power play. Pats goes to Netzcash. He holds it in. Now Quinn. Lost it to Alfredson. He runs, struck a fan on it. Puck goes all the way out to center ice. And now the Jets have a man advantage.
We expect so much of these young players in today's game, and there isn't a core group around players like Bach and Digg to show them the ropes. You're bringing a player into an expansion situation with not a lot of natural leader. There certainly isn't a Mark Messier on the Ottawa Senators, and that really hurts players like the young players as well.
Gets it to Digg. Digg slides it back to Modre. Shot. Rebound. Here's the shot by Bach. It's in the crease, and they can't finish it off. Jorski. His pass blocked by Kachuk. And now Modre. Over to Hill. Hill gets up across the line. Look save. Netzcash sends it off the glass. The penalty is over. Bio is met by King, who waited for him in the neutral zone.
Biel was lucky. He just saw King at the last second out of the corner of his eye.
To the point, Hill, in front, Alfredson puts it wide. Olchek trying to clear. Hill at the point, long shot. Manson trying to help his goaltender to tie up the puck. Now Kachuk and Netzcash did a little shoving. Grabbed by Turcotte. 10 seconds left in the period. Turcotte lost it. Here's Quinn looking for some help. Finds some in Digg. Digg goes outside. Manson knocks him down. Puck is hit back to the blue line. Goes all the way. And that should run out. It does run out the period.
And the Ottawa Senators really dominated the second period. Khabibulin was just outstanding. But the Senators are still having a tough time scoring goals. And the coaching change certainly hasn't changed that so far.